Hey guys, my name's Emma and I'm from MGEMS and I'm currently studying geoconservation as a master's. I'm here at the Etches Collection today and I thought I would take you to Kimmeridge Bay with me and we're going to take a look at the fossils. Now, if you've never been here, I really recommend having a look because the ammonites and other fossils you can see here are really amazing to look at and you might be fortunate and get a bit of a better day than I managed to pick today. But I just thought I would mention a little bit about the safety precautions you should take and also the fossil hunting code. So here at Kimmeridge, you're not allowed to fossil hunt unless it's ex situ material in the foreshore. So just come here, enjoy the fossils for what they are. If there's anything scientifically valuable, the Etches Collection and Steve will collect it and preserve it for your benefit. But just come down here, look around and see what you can find. But there are a few safety issues, let's say. So where the ammonites are, they're in these kind of large slabs and they're extremely slippery. So be very careful when you are walking. And also the cliffs are always unstable. So whilst you're down here, you may hear little falls of rocks and they're normally on the smaller scale, but just don't go too near them because you will potentially put your life at risk and it's never worth that. No fossil is worth that. And then also the tides as well. So just come here, enjoy the fossils, but just enjoy them for what they are and enjoy your day. So I've just taken a little walk around and they're very easy to spot. You just kind of have to walk slowly and you'll see they're almost like little disc shapes and there's just ammonites all over the place. So there's two lovely specimens here and you can see they're kind of orange colouring in where the shell's been replaced. And they are fragile and they are crushed, but you can clearly see what they are. And it's really, really good fun to come down here and see how many you can spot because they are all over the place. The more you look, the more you'll find. So there's some around here and then if we move over, we can see if we can find some more. So there's another one here and you'll see like fragments all over the place. So you just have to kind of, once you get the eye for them, you'll spot them and it's really good fun. So you can see they're just all over the place and they do get attacked by the waves quite regularly, obviously with the tides coming in, and it does damage them. But when these ones are worn away, another set are revealed underneath, and that's the beauty of it. It's kind of, you know, they are getting destroyed, but it's, you can come and enjoy them and it's just the natural process of them. So really cool. So the terrain of the beach here at Kimmeridge isn't suitable for everyone. You have got to be very careful, especially in weather like this. It is a slippery beach and then it's just a load of boulders everywhere. And that just shows you that these boulders have come from somewhere. You've got cliff collapses, you've got, you know, dangerous tides. So just take your time with this place, but there's a lot that can be found. So we're going to take a wander now and see what else we can find. So here we have a slightly smaller ammonite specimen, but it's also got the node still intact. So you can see it's been worn by the sea a lot, but you can see these little dots here, and they're all the nodes on the whorls going around here. So it's a really nice thing to see that they're still kind of preserved and they haven't been completely washed away. Here we have what appears to be a fragment of an ammonite, and what we can see is the lovely coarse ribbing of this species. And the beauty of ribbing and suture lines is it can help us identify the different species of ammonite that we're looking at, which is really useful to dating and aging the rock because of biostratigraphy. So that is literally using the different ammonite species as an age guide to correlate the rocks. So they have a use and they're not just pretty, the ribs. So here in this loose boulder here, we've got what appears to be fossilized wood. So the actual, most of the wood has washed away or it's disappeared, but you can see the kind of darker material here of the remains that is left. So it's really cool to see here because I don't know if this is a super common thing to see. It's mainly the ammonites in the foreshore area, but there was definitely some organic material here, which is pretty cool.